Hi everyone, come back to our wisdom in online classes. That is second class for you, 8th standard. In previous class, we have discussed about two paragraphs regarding a day in the ashram. It was about early in the morning. Now, we look on to the third paragraph, what happens in the third paragraph after the early morning session. Okay, go through the textbook. Third paragraph. After an interval, each boy takes his asana, his square of carpet, into the fields and sits down on it to meditate in his own place alone. Later on, before the school work begins, the boys all stand together in the shade of the trees and sing their hymn. See, in the second paragraph we have seen what happens in the early morning. A troop of boys who are called as choristers will rise or awake in the early morning and they used to sing some devotional songs around the ashram. Is it? In after interval means after taking some time, what they will do? Each boy takes his asana. Means while you are going to yoga, you are doing some asanas. Is it like Padmasana, Vajrasana, like that? They are also used to do yoga here in their square carpet. Means there will be one carpet which is used to sit on the to do yoga. So here also they will take their own carpet and they go to the fields and they place that square carpet and they will sit on it and they go on doing meditation. Alone, they sit alone. If you are going to yoga here, means there will be one place and everybody sit one by one like that, is it? But here there is no restrictions like that. Means they used to take their carpet and they can go anywhere. They can sit alone and they used to meditate for themselves. There is no instructions for them. There is no instructor actually. Already they have their own idea of their yoga or meditation. Okay, later on, before the school work begins, means after yoga and after getting bath and everything, later on, before the school work begins, means before the school work, before the school work means here, the school work starts from 10 o'clock, is it? The school work starts from 10 o'clock, but in the ashram, in the early morning only they start working, but actually here school work means reading, writing or anything. Okay, before that work, all the boys stand together in the shade of the trees and sing their hymn. You see, what a beautiful feeling they are experiencing. Just because when you come to school, there is a prayer form. Is it? There is a prayer. What will you do? All of you are standing in the corridor and you will sing some national anthem or prayers like that. But here, the students are standing under the tree shades, means under the tree shades they used to stand in their own group and they will sing their hymn, means they will sing their own devotional song, they will sing the prayer to the God. Okay, this is just like a prayer. Next comes the fourth paragraph. Look onto your textbook. Till about 10:30, the work of the school goes on. Means 10:30 means up to 10:30 the school goes on, means they continue learning their ideas. We have no classrooms. The boys sit with their teachers in the open air under the trees. See here, they don't have any classrooms. Here school means there will be one room and there are some benches and seat arrangements have done for you. You are sitting in your own place. You sit and you have to bring some books and bag with you. And you used to write or read whatever the teacher teaches you. Okay. But in ashram, there were no rooms. There were no rooms. They are sitting with the teachers under the tree. Just like Gurukula system. In the ancient system also, you might have seen this in your some films. Ancient films just like Hoysala. There will be one saint sitting under the tree and all the students are surrounding him. They used to discuss their ideas. Is it like this? Here also there is no classrooms. They have to sit under the tree in a open air along with their teachers. There are no larger classes. A group of 8 or 10 boys are seated around the teacher asking him questions. You see here, it's very interesting. There is no syllabus for them. There is no hurry to complete the syllabus. What they are doing, just they are sitting with the teachers and go on asking the doubts which they have. Means they go on asking the questions and the teacher will answer for those questions. Means there is a healthy discussion between the students as well as teacher. And the group is, there are no lot of members, large number of students there. There are only 8 to 10 members. Means it is a very small groups will be available for 8 to 10 members. There is one teacher. Okay. Very few books are used. A greater part is carried on through conversation. You see here, there is no number of books you are taking. Just like each subject has subdivisions like that. You see that. But here, very few books are used and most of their learning is able only through conversation. Means the last questions and the teacher will answer for that. The conversation will be going on every day. By that, the students will clear their doubts easily. The boys soon learn to open out all the difficulties to the teachers and the teachers get keenly interested in boys' questions and answers. You see here, the boys soon learn to open all the difficulties. Means if there is such a type of relation, if the teacher sits with the students under the tree, there will be open air. It is a pleasant thing happening there. That is, a good relationship is between going on in between the boys and the teachers. At that time, what happens? The students feel very happy or he will open up with his questions to the teacher. And teacher is available for them easily and he will ask the questions as well as he will get the answer for it. Okay. The boys soon learn to open out all the difficulties to the teachers and the teachers get keenly interested in boys' questions and answers. You just see, not only the boys open up with the teachers, even teachers also have keen interest to answer for the questions which the boys ask in the ashram. Okay, the teachers have more patience to answer for the questions of the students here. Such a living education can never be dull. What he explains, C.F. Andrews explains that such a living education would never be dull. Means if such good conversations is going on between the students and the teachers, it will never become dull. They never get bored, or teachers will never get bored, and there will be definitely a learning outcome. Okay, my dear students, in your textbooks they have given answer question and questions for you regarding these 4 paragraphs. We shall have a look on it. I will say the answers also now, question with answer, but only a word I will say. What you have to do is, your homework is, here C1 questions is there, no? For that, you have to write the complete answers. Means, in a complete sentence, you have to write. Keep it in your mind, whenever you write answers for languages, especially Kannada, Hindi and English, these 3 languages are, you are studying in your high school session now. For 3 languages also, if you want to write answers, you have to write complete sentence. Okay, this is very important for you. Okay, we shall have a look on it. First one, who named the school Shantiniketan? Yes, in yesterday class I have told you that who named the Shantiniketan. Yes, very good. Gurudeva is none other than Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, you write it completely. Then, when does the day in Shantiniketan begin? Yes, very good. The in Shantiniketan, the day begins in the early morning. What is termed by Gurudeva as the darling of our hearts? It is nothing but Shantiniketan. The answer is Shantiniketan. Which phrase used in the paragraph 1 means both the old and the young people? Means one, in the first paragraph he has explained that both old and young who visit the Shantiniketan. experience, is it? Which phrase represents both old and young means here? All. All is a phrasal form. Next, the boys in Shantiniketan get up early in the morning. Who else are they early risers? Means here, who are the early risers? They are none other than choristers. The troop of choristers. Okay, my dear students, I have told answers for you. What you have to do is you have to write it in a complete sentence. We shall see next paragraphs in our next session. Thank you.